73rd play for the Clemson offense as we're just starting the fourth quarter. Tony Elliott telling us the goal is around 80 plays. Wearing down an Alabama defense is part of the plan in the fourth quarter. It's a defense from Bama that is incredibly talented, but doesn't have the depth that they've had in the past.
They ran 90 plays a year ago. Tracking toward that, you're right, against the defense, not as deep. Watson for the end zone. Williams, touchdown. He is the premier red zone receiving weapon in college football, targeted so often and so many touchdowns, 11 now this season.
He's going to run into not only his defensive back, but he affects Minkah Fitzpatrick. Does a good job of making it look as if he's going out for the route to try to sell it, but does a better job of affecting Marlon Humphrey and Minkah Fitzpatrick, who was man-to-man that time with Mike Williams. It is at fourth and one. Brings another tight end, doesn't hesitate. How about Steve Sarkisian? He's been an offensive analyst the whole year. Lane Kiffin's been calling the plays, and now he's about to call one of the biggest plays of his life without Bo Scarborough.
Harris slams forward in the tie. Keep the drive alive at the 48. They kept it simple.
Keep it simple and you go right to the play sheet. This is what it calls for in this situation. We get to a third. Ross Pierce Baker and they pick up the first down.
And a couple of tight ends also blocking on the left side. Inside of 3 minutes. Hurts. Backward pass to Stewart. He could throw it. Looks downfield for Howard, who makes a catch at the Clemson 30. A trick play dialed up by Sark.
We just talked before they started the series. Steve Sarkisian is probably had kept a play or two back. Chris Stewart to the big tight end that time. O.J. Howard, who makes another big play for the Crimson Tide in a national championship game.
High school quarterback, remember, Ardarius Stewart, shows that he's still got the arm to pick up 24 yards. Hurts now took a peek downfield and now just barrels forward, still running in the clear and scores. And the veteran's brilliance is answered by the rookie's moxie, Kirk, and Bama reclaims the lead.
A legend is born here tonight in Tampa in Jalen Hurts. When he pulls it down the run, he's a tailback. He's not a guy that's looking to get down. He's 6'2 and 210 pounds. Watch the linebackers clear out. Linebackers clear out, man coverage. Now he just shows you what makes him such a special athlete. Pretty good effort by Forrestall as well on a block to see his quarterback taking off. He turns around and picks up a nice block.
I was going to say, Hurts wasn't the only true freshman to make a nice play. That Miller Forrestall is a true freshman tight end who just planted the defender. Overcame a third and 16 early in that drive from their own 26-yard line. They take it 68 yards in 2.5 minutes. But Watson's got time. Plenty of it. And Fuller tries to set it up in good field position. Oh, C.J. Fuller was in the clear and was just brought down by Tony Brown there. A saving tackle.
Wow. How about the heroics here late in this game? These two teams, much like last year, just going back and forth. It looked like Alabama's there. Once they missed that first tackle, he gets out in the open with room to run.
There was nobody but the kicker behind him.
Tony Brown makes that play. Comes up a little bit lame on his shoulder, but stays in the game.
So here's Deshaun from the 32. A field goal to perhaps force overtime, a touchdown to win it.
The last touchdown was under 2 minutes. And they move right down the field.
It's a short catch. Leggett able to get out of bounds. Tigers have a couple timeouts to work with.
Important thing for that front four. Remember, we have athlete Clemson now at 90 plays offensively. We've not seen a lot of rotation. fatigue, mental fatigue, physical fatigue for Bama? Can they tough it out and still contain and pressure number four, get after him and not give him time to throw?
And bring pressure, but it's picked up. And Williams down the sideline makes another big catch. He beat Averett. The Tigers threaten again.
That's a matchup you're going to take. If you're going to leave Mike Williams one-on-one with a corner who's undersized, notice how he puts it up in the air to give Williams at 6'3", who can leap up close to 40 inches, give him a chance to go up and make a play. Nice job of seeing that by Deshaun Watson.
Now they get him to Scott, who laterals to Gallman, who is hit immediately but stays alive. And Gallman spinning and driving down inside the 35. There was a lot going on there. Trickery from the Tigers this time.
Yeah, throw out to the receiver, lateral back to Wayne Gallman. You're right. And then Alabama actually defended it pretty well.
It looked like the Tigers were saving up a couple plays for a big moment, too.
Two timeouts closing in on 1 minute here.
Watson takes off, but will be dropped. A short gain. It'll be third down. Ryan Anderson got him inside of a final minute. Clock running.
Clemson electing to hold on to those timeouts. Worst case scenario, they're thinking about trying to get this game into overtime.
Well, I'll tell you, they're not playing with a whole lot of urgency here, are they?
Third and three. He needs 5 yards to feel really good about having a chance to get it into overtime.
Walk for Huber is 47. Sitting from that distance in warm-up. On third down, Watson slant. One more time, Renfrow, and they have a first down. And they are in Hugo's field goal range now with 22 seconds to go.
They have a cushion there with one of their better receivers in the slot. They save the timeouts and just fire the ball into the ground here.
Tell you what, though, they do wait a long time to spend a timeout and really create some urgency here. Want to obviously save one timeout for a potential field goal attempt, but I'm a little surprised they weren't looking more aggressively to win the game with a touchdown here.
Sure, at the very least, maybe a couple shots into the end zone.
Well, they can do that. And still the timeouts, but just 19 seconds now.
You've got to believe they're going to have a safety over the top of Mike Williams, who's down here at the bottom.
A sack could take them out of field goal range. Bama brings some heat. Watson delivers. Catch made down inside the 10 by Leggett. 14 seconds to go.
Now Clemson will use one of their timeouts here. Dabo all the way down to the 10-yard line. What an effort, Chris, by Jordan Leggett. It's full extension. Redeeming himself for earlier the miscommunication with Deshaun Watson. Fully extended, makes that catch and shows you for a tight end how athletic he is. I think that ball touched the ground. I think he got his right elbow underneath.
He missed a much easier catch and made a very, very difficult grab that time. Wow. Jordan Leggett has been the clutch guy. We talked about the game winners against Louisville, the game winner against Florida State, and a huge play. And now, a really intriguing setup with the ball at the 9-yard line.
You're at the 9-yard line, you still have a timeout, which is big for them, whether they set up for potentially a game-time field goal or you take a shot in the end zone. Probably have a couple plays here, depending on what happens with that first play. But we left Glendale last year thinking, man, what a great national championship with these two teams. And here we are with the second opportunity to see these teams again in a championship. And, man, it's been...
How do you like the sequel, Herbie?
The sequel's been pretty good. And I think we're just... We're just getting started here. We may have some more football to be played.
Now we'll see. Hugo, not automatic, but it looks like the best Bama can hope for would be a field goal attempt in overtime. Let's see if the Tigers can win it right here. Williams to the left. Watson. End zone. Overthrown. Like it well defended that time.
It took 5 seconds off the clock.
Notice they put Minka Fitzpatrick on number 16, one of their best cover guys. 9 seconds, one timeout.
And Chris, that last play
pulling Mike Williams into the boundary to the left. Not only does he have the corner Everett on him, he also has a safety, number 6, Hootie Jones. So you're using two defenders to try to take him away. That should open up one-on-one opportunities off to the right, which includes Jordan Leggett, and also don't forget about Hunter Renfro, who's in that slot in the middle.
Watson lobs it for the end zone. Williams is knocked down. Here comes a flag. Interference in the end zone. We'll put the ball at the 2-yard line. There are 6 seconds to play.
Force Mike Williams back to the inside, but then just grabs a hold of him. Everett pushes him.
Defense, number 28. Foul occurred in the end zone. By rule, ball be placed at the 2-yard line. First down.
He did a great job with his technique to force him to where his help is, where the safety is. But then once he gets by him, he reaches around his waist to hold him.
How great is this? This could be the final play of the college season, perhaps, if Clemson gets a touchdown to win it. If Bama can hold him out, perhaps a field goal attempt for overtime. Watson. Touchdown!
Touchdown,
and then do what he does best, go down and make clutch catches.